Hi and welcome to a special episode of Ruko School. This is my video number 50, so I thought I'd make something special out of this one. So let's have a quick look at the evolution of the Ruko sidebar system, and it all started back around 1980, 40 years ago, at this iconic key, the Ruko Twin 6000. And the sidebar system was invented by Bo Widin in Adasa, and of course it was shared along the family, so Ruko got this Twin 6000 as well. And it took a regular 6-pin pin tumbler and added a second locking element with 5 sidebar pins and a sidebar, so that prevented the block from turning unless all 5 sidebar pins were in the perfect position and allowed for the block to turn. So this did forever change the way we looked at security. So but of course nothing is perfect when it's in the first product, so there were room for improvement, as we can see when we move on. But one of the things that wasn't a success with this one is actually, if we look here, we can see that the gate positions are spread around. That because the code of the key needs to correspond with the code on the sidebar. So that means that even though this sidebar can be flipped 180 and support a second code, you would need to carry multiple sidebars on the car if you had to change out a lock or repin something that was broken. So the reason that they had these different sidebars was because they made the sidebar pins identical, so there was only one sidebar pin. And as it's more or less a natural thing, we can see here that's filled up with false gates, so there are 4 false gates and a true gate in the middle, and all the pins were the same. So it was a great system. I mean, thus until recently it was still possible to find these old locks in the field, but they are only the few left. They are upgraded by now by most companies, and they are harder and harder to find, but there are still a few out there. And outside Denmark and apparently in America, they are still the big hit, because what happened in Denmark was actually that the patent for the key profile expired after the like 25 years that's normally on patents on keys. So that means that you were no longer sure that nobody would be able to get a copy of your key. So that made this one not so interesting to keep, and it was time to move on. And as we can see, there's been some interesting changes over the years. So this was how it all started, and let's move on. Second, I'll just say that Ruko has always been doing 2 different types of products. There's the master key systems for the companies, and then there's the end user products that also want a high security level. So this is the Ruko Combi. It's again an 11 pin key and 11 pin lock, key with 11 cuts. And when we look at the sidebar cuts, we can see that the spacing is a bit different. So there's a wider space between these two than between these two. And that's because they added a second element now that they were going to redo the whole thing. First of all, the reason this one is called Combi is actually because we can see here this one doesn't have some sidebars, so you could use that for your less important doors, and then you could have a high security sidebar system on your external doors to secure your building. and you only needed to have one key for everything. So that's the whole point with the Ruko, one key for everybody. And then you just set your access rights, and you can cut costs by not having a sidebar on less important doors. I mean, even though they don't have a sidebar, we still have six pins and security drivers, so we are still way above most of the international products when we talk about basic low level of security. So to have a system like this one, all the information about all the keys and the subkeys and how the cylinders are, that information is held by a Ruko, or in some cases by a local locksmith. So someone need to keep track of all this data, and to get more locks or more get more keys, you'll either provide with a signature or a pin code or a combination. But for the average user, it's not that easy to keep track of all these things. And if a system is based with one locksmith, then you would need to go to that one locksmith to get more keys. So they decided to make another system for the end users. This is a security card. This is Ruko Garant. That's the first product that's based on the Ruko Combi 1100 system. So this one holds all the information. This is these first five letters is a code for the sidebar cuts, and these six ones are a code for the regular key pins from the tip to the bow. And then later it came with the Garant 10. It's basically the same system, it's just another profile. And this one has about 20 different sidebars. And of course, it then developed into the Garant Plus, also for the home user. And these are the three generations for, because this one is actually still the one you would have if you want something secure on your home. And I mean, alternatively, you have this, the D12s, if you don't want ultra security. And it comes with this, still again, it comes with a code that you need to get more keys. But unlike with these ones you need to bring the card to have copies. This one can be copied without bringing the code, you just need to bring a key. So it's less secure, but it's still way above what most people see in other countries. So let's take a Ruko Garant apart and just find the follower. Again, just a quick note that there is this gap where the C clip used to be, but whenever you have a stock lock, you do not need to shim it. That's not how it works. You can always pull a stock lock apart without using a shim when it's a Ruko. You don't need to worry about shims. That is not necessary. And if we look here, we can actually see how these fingers on the sidebar pins are in various positions. So that's the gaps that you could see that was different between the sidebar cuts. And that's because we have six different sidebar pins, but they're actually only four heights. So that's why they also changed the angle. And if we have a quick look in here, we can actually see here the six different types of sidebar pins, numbers 1 to 6. And if we just grab a single pin here, and we can see, if we can get some focus on this thing, we can see that there are filled with serrations everywhere to make it harder to pick, or basically in a real world scenario I would say impossible to pick. So of course it can be picked, but that's not really a solution if You just need to work with someone in a logout situation. And as we can see here again with the sidebars, now we went from the really narrow gates on the Twin 6000 to these wide gates here with full observations again that can snag in and lock on everything. And as this thing needs to also partly rotate to get in space, there are serrations in all directions that just makes it even harder to pick. So we had this for a long time. It was the Grand 10. There's the Combi 1100, and they also made some that's locksmith specific. There's some that called Combi 2, and there's Combi 900, and there's just the sales names. They are basically the same Combi, and as we can see here, they come with a huge variety of restricted profiles, and some of these even make use of a profile tree, so that you can have this is one keyway, and then you can have some more open keyways that will fit multiple keys, so you can even expand this by using different profiles and different levels of warding in the plugs. So that adds another level of security, because you can actually basically have the same key code on two keys but the different profiles, and therefore you can expand your system. But that's still a thing from the past. Next up, we got the Grand Plus that we took apart in a previous video. Should go and check that. That's the one where we compare the DP to the Grand Plus. And if we just pop this one out quickly, we can see that we now have a sidebar with an ultra narrow gate system again. So we went from the wide gates to the narrow gates, and on top of that, we can see that we have now 10 sliders. So they are no longer spring loaded. They are funneled in by the tip of the key, and they are set in different heights. But as this is for the end user, this one only holds. That's not the one. Just put that in position 3. And just put this back together before everything goes pear-shaped. And let's just take this one here. And maybe we should put it in from the right. There we go. But for the companies, we used the DP. And what makes the DP so unique is when we look at the sidebar pin from the Grand Plus. First of all, they are filled with tiny serrations as well. I mean, why wouldn't there be? There's no need to make picking any easier. But with the DP, you could actually expand your system, your master key system, by allowing for multiple sidebars to open the same lock. And as we can see, this one actually has two true gates as well. So two different sidebars could open this lock. So that makes your combinations extremely higher than that. So that was the last generation. So from there, we for the TPO market, we went on with this, as we know by now, it's the D12. And that doesn't have a sidebar, so it's only the 12 cuts and the extreme paracentric keyway that makes this a bit harder to pick. So And of course, as I said before, whenever you have a business and you need something with master keys, you can have this one. This is Ruko Merkur. And Merkur is, as we can see here, it also has a extreme paracentric keyway. And if we look at the key, we can see it's definitely crossing over multiple times. So this one is just like the D12, but this one allows for master keying. A combination of different cuts as well as regular master key wafers inside. So, but if you have a business and you don't want to go with the cheap low level security with a key control, you can have what's called the Triton. And Triton is, if we have a look at this one, we can see that this is actually now going back to the old style sidebar again, unlike the sliders version on the Grand Plus. And we still have the cuts up here, the double cuts. So we have pins like on the D12, but with the sidebar. And we can now see that we are actually, even though the everything related to Merkur and Triton are this copper color, so you can tell them apart. And this one looks extremely like our good old Combi 1100 sidebar. And unlike with the Combi 1100, that we had different levels of security, that it was either no security or for the 5-pin extra security. With the Triton, they have now decided to go with two different versions of sidebar. So you either have 2 sidebar pins or 5 sidebar pins. So there's no security pins on the sidebar. But that's because the sidebar coding is again part of the master key system. And if we take a look at one of these sidebar pins, we can actually see that it also has multiple gates. So this one's, and again, we can actually see that these two gates are, one is a center gate and one is a side gate. So that shows that we again still use the thing where this would turn a little bit to align. And again, this is the short one that only supports the 2 sidebar pins. So this is the low level of security in the Triton. So we've come quite a long way from back when it all started with this iconic Twin 6000 and up to the insane Triton key, that's the one we have now, and of course with everything from the Combi up to the Triton here, you can add a click functionality on top of the, if you want ultra key control. But yeah, there's just so many nice features. I mean, it's really amazing to live in Scandinavia and be able to have these products at hand. And when I see some of the things that people are stuck with around the world, I would just say that I'm just proud of the Danish level of security that we have here. And that's all for this one. If you have any questions, please put a comment, and I might be able to go into more details with some of these products if you want to see more videos with a certain one of them where we take them more into details and have a look inside. But otherwise, just have a great weekend and see you soon. Bye for now.